get a hold of one too. He knew planes. And he's trying to identify this. And it's flying in a very erratic manner, which was very puzzling to us. But this is 61. We've heard, well, actually, most days they call them flying saucers. We had no idea what a flying saucer looked like. But we had no fear, just curiosity. We were trying to identify this craft.
Decide to pull over. Barney gets out of the car.
Actually, that was in the Indian Head area.
Okay. Am I preceding something here when you encountered alien entities, or was this after?
No, this is the next step.
Okay.
In the Indian Head area, I'm trying to attract the attention of this craft. I'm telling it, come on in. Hi. I got the window down. I'm yelling to it. Hi, hi. Who are you? I can't feel something still. There you go. And at that point, it left the top of the mountain, came out over the highway, and stopped in midair directly in front of us, maybe about 50 feet in the sky. So Barney got out with the binoculars in an attempt to identify the craft. And when he looked up, he saw a circular window with a bright light behind it, and he saw these men standing behind the window looking down at him. And at that point, the craft began to descend. And he became frightened. Ran back to the car, saying he thought they were trying to capture him. So we got in the car, and we went speeding down the highway to avoid capture. And as we're driving along, there's beeping sounds. That sounds like something was hitting the trunk of the car, and the car vibrated. And then we drove along for about another 30 miles, when Barney turned off onto a side road. And here were the group of men he'd seen on the craft standing in the middle of this road, blocking our way. And naturally, he had to stop the car. And they came up in two groups, took us out of the car, path in the woods to where the craft was underground.
Going through your head, thoughts that weren't your own. Did you have some sort of telepathic communication with these entities, or?
Our communication was verbal.
Verbal?
Right.
Oh, interesting.
Yep, they spoke English in a limited way. Like, a foreigner coming here and not too well acquainted with our language.
But in the same time, using common colloquialisms of the day, like, you'll be back in no time or something of that ilk.
In the very first part, they had us under some kind of control. And I brought myself out of this, but Barney was only able to bring himself partly out of it. So that I was just as conscious as I am right now.
They walk you into the craft up a ramp. The landed craft. This is right off Route 3. Well, actually, you didn't know where you were at that point.
And
But the last...
Right after Route 2.
So they walk you up this ramp. You brought in, and what did they say they were going to do with you?
Well, when we got up to the door, I was not going to go in. So I signed them.
You punched the entity?
Yeah. In fact, I put up such a battle that my dress was badly torn. And he said, you know, come on. All we want to do is some simple tests. And as soon as the tests are over, we'll take you back to your car and you'll be on your way.
Thank you. Thank you. Just let go. You're magnificent. If you listen, you can feel it. You're divine. You are ecstasy. And you are sex. We'll be right back.
Thank you. these two. Put them outside.
express to me if you feel ecstasy.